polypeptide chains. Now we are going to see the diancyl chloride method to identify the N-terminal amino acid. In the previous slide, we had seen Edman degradation procedure to tag the N-terminal amino acid. Here we have diancyl chloride. Actually, what is diancyl chloride? 5-dimethylamino-1-naphthalene-sulfonyl chloride. That is what is called diancyl chloride. This diancyl chloride is allowed to react with the polypeptide chain. This is the polypeptide chain. Just look here, it has an N-terminal residue. And after the reaction, what happens? Diancyl polypeptide is produced. This SO2 is there. This chloride ion or chlorine is going out in the form of HCl. And this SO2 is reacting with this NH. SO2 and NH. So we have the diancyl polypeptide. This diancyl polypeptide, diancylated polypeptide, is reacted with aqueous acid at high temperature. What happens? We get diancylated N-terminal amino acid. Here there is an amino acid. It is the N-terminal amino acid. This N-terminal amino acid is diancylated. So there is a hydrolysis here. So diancyl amino acid, diancylated N-terminal amino acid is free here. And the rest of the amino acids are also there. And we can identify this diancylated N-terminal amino acid after its chromatographic separation from the rest of the amino acids. And this is a fluorescent amino acid. Because of the diancyl group, the whole molecule is fluorescent. That means it glows in darkness. It is very much convenient to identify. Of course, by means of chromatography procedure, we can easily identify this amino acid. Only that much about sequencing of polypeptides. Now we are moving on to the secondary structure of proteins. So far we were dealing with the primary structure. What's meant by the term secondary structure? A secondary structure is the local spatial arrangement of a polypeptide's backbone. The local spatial arrangement of a polypeptide's backbone without considering the conformations of their side chains. When we study the secondary structure, we consider only the backbone and we do not consider the side chains or the other attachments to the amino acids. There are two types of secondary structure. One is called alpha helix, the other is beta pleated sheet. Both alpha helix and beta pleated sheet have repeated interactions due to the hydrogen bonding between the amide NH group and also the carbonyl group of the peptide backbone. Remember, the peptide backbone has a hydrogen donor. It is the amide NH group and it has also a hydrogen acceptor, the carbonyl group. So between them, actually hydrogen bonds are formed. Remember, conformations of the side chains are not considered when we study the secondary structure. You see, when we come to the secondary structure, two types of angles are very important. Which are they? Look here. Here is the alpha carbon. Alpha carbon of any amino acid. On one side, we have a carbonyl carbon, while on the other side, we have an amino nitrogen. This amino nitrogen is attached with this alpha carbon. This carbonyl carbon also is attached with this alpha carbon. So, two types of free rotations are possible. Which are they? One is this rotation of this bond. It is called a phi bond. It is actually the the angle of rotation of this bond, the bond between amino nitrogen and alpha carbon. And what is this psi angle? It is the angle of rotation of this bond between carbonyl carbon and alpha carbon. Since these two are single bonds, these groups can rotate around these bonds. And this much is considered as a plane, an amide plane. This much is another amide plane. This plane may be considered as a card, you know, sometimes in your home when you are free, when you are enjoying yourself, you may play cards. Playing cards are there in your home sometimes. So just like that playing card, this is a card actually. This is considered a card, amide plane. This amide plane can rotate with respect to this amide plane. That rotation is possible because of these two bonds. Okay, let us come here. The phi and the psi angles of the peptide backbone. Definition of the angles that determine the conformation of a polypeptide chain. Which ones? Phi and psi. The rigid planar peptide group is called a playing card structure. They are shaded. This much structure is rigid. Means the bonds are stable and the constituent atoms cannot rotate with respect to each other. This much part of the molecule also is stable, which means the atoms cannot rotate with respect to each other. But this plane can rotate with respect to this plane. I think you understood now. The angle of rotation around the alpha carbon nitrogen bond is called phi bond. Which one? This one, alpha carbon nitrogen bond. This is called a phi bond. And the angle of rotation around the alpha carbon carbonyl carbon bond is designated psi bond, which is that one, this one, alpha carbon carbonyl carbon. These two bonds are the ones around which there is free rotation possible. There is a freedom of rotation possible around these two carbons. You just understand like this. This card can rotate with respect to this card. Or this card can rotate with respect to this card. I think it's now clear. Phi is equal to 180 and psi also is equal to 180. Come back to the alpha helical structure. Did you understand anything from here? Let us begin from this side. Alpha helix is something like a coiled spring. Along the backbone, you can see alpha carbon, nitrogen, alpha carbon, nitrogen, carbonyl carbon, alpha carbon, nitrogen, carbonyl carbon. You can see the whole backbone structure. The backbone structure is just coiling like a spring. And look from here. This is a carbon atom. Which carbon? Carbonyl carbon. And this is an amino nitrogen. You can see the NH group. This carbon has a double bonded oxygen atom. And this carbon is attached with the alpha carbon. So this much is actually forming an amino acid. Alpha carbon, carbonyl carbon. And here we have the next nitrogen. This nitrogen, carbon, carbon. This much is forming an amino acid. While this nitrogen, this carbon and the next carbon is not shown there, that much makes up another amino acid. The bond between carbonyl carbon and amino nitrogen is called peptide bond. So in this diagram, here is the peptide bond. The bond between amino nitrogen and carbonyl carbon. Can you see that the molecule is just bending like this? The molecule is bending. Carbon, carbon, nitrogen, this carbon, carbon, nitrogen, carbon. Can you see here like this? So the molecule is bending here. Okay. This is actually what is called the alpha helix. And one turn of the helix. Can you see here? The helix means it is something like a spring. One turn means this much this tens. This much is 110. That can be seen here also. Starting from an alpha carbon, it is coming here like this, bending and folding. It is coming here 110. Again, it is coming here and it is moving and it is coming here next 10 like that. This coiled structure is stabilized by hydrogen bond. Where is the hydrogen bond? This is a carbonyl oxygen. This is a force of attraction which we call hydrogen bond towards an amino nitrogen. Here amino nitrogen is not shown, but here you can see it very clearly. This is an oxygen atom, and here you have NH. That hydrogen is attracted by this oxygen. This oxygen is attracted towards this. Like that, you know, there is the force of attraction. And one more is there. Yes, this is another NH. Nitrogen, hydrogen attracted by oxygen. So there is the force of attraction called hydrogen bonding between the carbonyl group and the amino group. Of course, the constituent amino acids are far away from each other because they are coiled like a spring. In the linear chain, they are far away from each other, but once they are coiled, they come closer to each other. You see, for every turn of the helix, 3.6 residues are there, 3.6 amino acids are there. And you know that one turn is equal to 360 degrees. One rotation is equal to 360 degrees. And in that 360 degree turn, there are 3.6 residues, 3.6 amino acids. Can you just find out what is the angle between any two close amino acids, any two nearby amino acids? At an angle of 360 degree, there are 3.6 residues. That means between any two amino acids, what must be the degree, or what is the degree angle by which two close amino acids differ from each other? Just try to find out. Okay? Yes, must be 100. Come back. The helix can be viewed as a stacked array of peptide planes hinged at the alpha carbons and approximately parallel to the helix. Remember, they are hinged at the alpha carbon, which means they are rotating with respect to the alpha carbons. Here you can see the alpha carbons very clear. This is an alpha carbon, like that you can see. Or let us come to the previous slide. Here also you can see, with respect to the alpha carbon. Alpha carbon is the hinge around which the other planes can rotate. Okay. This is a space filling model, and we are familiar with this model also now. And what about a beta pleated sheet? Beta pleated sheet is actually folding of the peptide backbone. Let us go to the next figure. You can see it here. This is just like the pleat of your dress, you know, maybe shirt or a pants, or when you're wearing a sari, you are folding some parts of it upon each other, and we say it's a pleat. And this beta pleated sheet is almost something like that. This polypeptide backbone is folded. In this case, this is a backbone, an amino acid backbone. This is another amino acid backbone, and they are parallel to each other, which means their carboxyl carbons are running in the same direction on both the strands. Carboxyl carbons are running in the same direction on both the strands, or we say nitrogen, or the amino nitrogen ends are running in the same direction for both the strands. And can you see here the hydrogen bonding? This is a carbonyl oxygen. This is an amino hydrogen. Between them, there is the force of attraction. This is what's called hydrogen bonding. Every now and then, there is a hydrogen bonding, which is ultimately responsible for the stabilization of this structure. And what about this structure? Here, the strands are anti-parallel. The strands are anti-parallel. Sometimes these two strands may be part of the same molecule formed by bending of the same molecule, or they may be part of different molecules. Accordingly, it may be intra-chain or inter-chain, these hydrogen bonds. Again, amino nitrogen is there. Nitrogen is having H atom, hydrogen atom. It is hydrogen bonded towards this carbonyl oxygen. So, this beta pleated sheet is stabilized by hydrogen bonding, just like the case of alpha helix. Another figure of a beta pleated sheet. Of course, these are actually anti-parallelly arranged. These two strands are anti-parallelly arranged. And you see here in this diagram, the chains, the adjacent chains do not fold back on each other, but they are in the extended conformation in this diagram. They are not completely folded upon each other, but we can see that they are about to fold. We can just see that they are about to fold. Again, it's very clear the hydrogen bonding between the oxygen and the hydrogen atoms of the nitrogen are very clear in this diagram as well. And we are going to the tertiary structure. We will see that in the next slide.